My name is Sue, and today we're going to talk a little bit more about UV resin. And I do have another video already up that talks about sticky UV resin. And I've had a lot of comments come across on that channel, or on that channel, excuse me, on that video that talk about the lamp that was used and the different types of resin that are out there and so forth. So I wanted to make another video to kind of address some of those thoughts and address some of the comments that I've gotten and do some further exploration. So let's get into it. Gonna cut from here to a scene that I took a while ago of me opening up my new UV light. So you'll take a look at that, and then we'll come back here and talk about. The only reason I'm showing this to you guys is because I wanted to make sure that you were kind of seeing the same thing I am. I ordered this from Amazon. I got it through Amazon Prime. It came yesterday, and I ordered it 2 days before that. So of course, as always, loving the shipping in Prime. Get everything really quickly. The only thing that I didn't like about it is that this is how it came, just like this. Now, I'm all for less boxes. Trust me, I don't care. That's great that they didn't ship it a box inside another box. I am perfectly fine with that. Let's reduce the waste. But this is how it came to me. I have not opened it yet. So you can see we have some a crushed corner here. It looks like somebody tried to get into it or they tried to pick it up. You can see that there. And then even worse, or I don't even know if it's worse, but strange. Can you see the, I don't know if it's really picking up here, but can you see the kind of rays in the box? Let's see if I turn it around. See how the top is like domed here? I can feel it and I can see that it is. So to me, it almost seems like, I don't know, something either got shifted around inside the box or it got repackaged. So I'm interested to see exactly what this looks like when we open it up. So I'm going to pause for a second. I'm going to put the camera somewhere and I'm going to show you what we're going to find when we open this up. Okay, we're back. So I have moved to a new spot and hopefully have some lighting that's going to work for us tonight. So here's the box, still unopened, still in a state that it came when I got it. So we're going to go ahead and open it. Grab some scissors. I know I'm dragging them towards my hand. I shouldn't be doing that. All right. I think that was the only tape on the entire box was right here that was hanging, holding it on. So that's kind of scary in and of itself. Okay. So open up the box. And here is the machine. And I know this is probably kind of close, but I'll put it off to the side for a second. And I have, oh, some little nail things, which won't be of any use to me. Some nail files, which again, well, these will come in handy. I can sand things down with these for sure. So these will be handy. And we have our power cord. So there wasn't really much packaging in the box to protect anything. And we have the instructions. So let's get this out of the way and take a look. Right, so this unwrapped, we'll see what it looks like. So there is the machine. And I know nothing about this machine other than what you're seeing here and the little bit that I know about it from what I read online. But this is a 72 watt Sun UV LED nail lamp. It has a 99 second low heat mode and then a double power mode. We'll have to read into that because I don't know what that means. Have a 10 second timer, 30 second timer, 60 second timer. It's It's got a fairly large chamber on the inside. Hopefully you guys can see that okay. And I believe, yep, that the whole tray in the bottom comes out. And that's nice. It's held in there by magnets, which is good. There's four magnets. Sometimes the tray is nice if you just want to pop things on there that need to go into the light. And other times you don't. All right. Well, this is the UV light that I bought. This is the one we'll be testing out in this video. So stay tuned for more to come in just a minute for you. Okay. So in past videos, we've spoken about a lot of the different UV resins that are on the market. There's this UV resin, which is just, I guess, a generic one. I'm sure, well, I'm not sure. I don't know if this is the name. I can't read the language, so my apologies there. But if there is a name, I don't readily see it here. But I did get this off Amazon. I have this resin. Oops. It's called Decorum. They make quite a few different products. And if you've watched my past resin videos, you know that this is my favorite. This is the one that I get. I've had questions about what this is. So the company is called Decorum. Hopefully you can see that there. It's a UV resin. It has a little pink teardrop. There might be other labels, but as long as it's Decorum, you have the right one. This is transparent, quick coating, toxic free. This is a 200 gram bottle. It has all the instructions about how to use it right here on the bottle. And anyway, I like it. It cures really nicely. So that's my tried and true one. I also have a bottle of Lutz resin, hard type, thin, clear UV resin. And then I had this bottle, which before in my last video, I didn't talk about the actual manufacturers, but this time I thought I would because this resin here is from Blue Moon Studio, which, if you're familiar with local craft stores, Blue Moon Studio makes a lot of beads. They also do a lot of jewelry making supplies, and they also have their own line of UV resin. In my past video, I did talk about this blue bottle and how I had a really hard time getting this to cure. So we're going to take a look at it again today with a different light that we already unboxed and looked at. Because it's a higher amperage or a higher wattage, we're going to see if it makes any difference with this resin. I also wanted to explain that I did already record this video once, and I stopped it because I wanted to address another thing about this particular resin, because I know this resin is very readily available. It's easy to get your hands on if you have craft stores, especially a Michaels near you. And it might work some, for some people very well. And if you watched my past video, this particular resin I had in a smaller bottle and I had no problems with it. So my fear is that this is just a really old bottle. And that could be causing some of my problems. So what I did yesterday is I went out and bought some new resin, not new, but a new bottle of resin. This is the same company. It's Blue Moon Studio. It's a smaller version of the same bottle here. It's exactly the same thing. It's UV craft resin. It's hard type. It's just a smaller bottle. This is 200 mil and this is 60 mil. So we're going to see if maybe something about this being a bigger bottle or just maybe having sat on the shelf for a long time because it is more expensive, people might not have bought it. Maybe that has something to do with it. Because it's a real shame. I did like the bottle that was small like this that I had bought previously. So we'll see if it makes any difference. So let's get into it. Okay, I have a mold here. Excuse me, I'm sorry. I have a frog in my throat today, apparently. And we're going to do one of these resins for each one of these corners of this mold. So I have my favorite, the Decorum, here in this left-hand corner. We're going to put it into this rectangle. Sorry if I'm causing a shadow here. I'm not trying to. I have a different light setup and I'm not sure if I like it yet. I have the Let's Resin Clear UV Resin that's going down here into this little triangle. This Amazon brand that I bought is going to go up here in the corner. And then our Blue Moon, the old one, is going to go down here in the circle. So that's the layout of what we're going to do. And then we'll put them in the lamp. Because I'm putting them all in the same mold, I'm going to cure them all for the same time. Now, before I do that, I do want to take a look at a couple of different things, the curing instructions. So for the Let's resin, it says UV lamp recommendations are 54 watt and above. Under the UV light, it's a cure time of 6 to 20 minutes. That's a long time. At least in my opinion, it's a long time. And then it gives you the other ideas or the other thoughts about cloudy and sunny days. Boy, I am tongue-tied today. I am so sorry. So we're going to take a look at this one, and we may have to cure this one a little bit longer. So we'll see. Well, we're probably going to have to cure it a little bit longer, but we're going to try to stay true to the package instructions and cure it for as long as it says to cure it for. The Blue Moon Studio does not come with instructions on the bottle. This one here, this one that I got off Amazon, it says with a 36 watt lamp, it takes 2 to 4 minutes. So this one is a short curing time. And then for the Decorum, it's exposure to UV light for 2 to 4 minutes. So this Decorum and this other brand here, 2 to 4 minutes. Let's resin. At least 6 minutes. And the Blue Moon Studio, we're going to take a look at together because I'm going to take it out of the package for the little bottle that I have. And right on the packaging instructions, it does say Blue Moon Studio UV LED lamp. Now, if you buy their UV LED lamp, it's very small. If you've ever seen it, it's really, the wattage isn't very high on it. So the cure time with their lamp says 2 to 4 minutes. So we'll see if that makes any difference under the other higher wattage lamp. Now I know that there's some schools of thought out there that say, if you cure it for too long, then it can be sticky. If you don't cure it long enough, it can be sticky. So, excuse me. So it's really up to you to kind of play with whatever resin you buy and see what works best for you. So let's get into it. I'm going to take this little bottle of this Amazon brand that I have. I'm just going to put some in here. Oh my gosh, this one has got bubbles galore. That's one thing you will see when you first open up your UV resin and tip it over. There will be a bubble that comes out of the tip usually, unless you turn it upside down. I actually saw a lady the other day that was shaking her resin, and I really wasn't sure why she was doing that. Because to me, that just would create an awful lot of bubbles, but to each his own. All right. So I'm going to stop talking. For the duration of this, I'm going to fast forward through it so you don't have to sit and watch me painstakingly do this in each one of these molds. Okay, so we're back. I've filled up all of the molds here. And for anybody that's a little concerned, yes, this is a larger dimension mold. The area, the space in it is bigger than some of these other ones. That makes no difference. The curing time is still the curing time. Matters not at all. What kind of mold dimensions you use. It does matter if your mold is clear. That will make a difference. So you may have to flip it over. This one is the clearest one I could find that I could demonstrate with here. So what I probably will do to give everything a good test is about halfway through the curing time, as long as everything is starting to cure on the top, I will flip it over. That way I can cure the backside of it. That's a good recommendation for anything unless you have a really good clear mold. Okay, so I have my lamp right here. I'm going to pop this in here. My lamp goes to 60 seconds, as we talked about in the video that I showed a little bit ago. So I'm going to put it on 60 seconds, and I'm going to do that for the 60 seconds twice, and then I'm going to flip them over, and then I'm going to continue to do it. Then we'll check it after 4 minutes for all of the resins except for the Let's resin. So we'll be right back. Okay, the first 2 minutes is done. As I said, I'm going to take this out and I'm going to keep it in its same orientation. That way, I'm not getting myself confused, even though I can go back and look at the video. So they are set up enough now that I can flip it over. So I'm going to flip it over, put it in for another 2 minutes, and we'll be right back. Okay, so it's all done now. 4 minutes, 2 minutes on each side of the mold for the decorum, for the blue moon, and for the Amazon brand. And then the Let's resin, the one down here in the corner, that's only gone in for 4 minutes. If you remember, the bottle on the back said that it would be cured in 6 to 20 minutes under the UV light. So we're going to have to put this one back through in order to give it an honest test. So I'm going to take the other ones out and we're going to take a look at them and see how they each performed and if they did what they were expected to do, because now I'm using a 72 watt lamp. So let's take the decorum out first. And remember, we've cured it on both sides, so we've given this the best chance that we can do it. It's been 4 minutes total. I've cured it on both sides. I've used the clearest mold that I had clean and available to me that wasn't being used already. So let's take this one out. Okay, first impressions. Not sticky at all. Absolutely no stickiness. It's nice and shiny. Does have a divot on the top of it because I didn't fill it all the way up. Could definitely put more resin in here, dome it, and then I'd have a perfectly good piece. So yeah, the decorum works exactly as promised, just like it does every time that I use it. So very good piece. All right, the next one is the Amazon one that I got. These all, well, most of them came from Amazon. This one, I just don't know the name of it. Pop this one out of here. And this one is maybe just the slightest bit tacky, but I wouldn't even really say that it's tacky. It's done very well in the light. So, yeah. Not sticky at all. Like, full on cured. All right, next is the Blue Moon. Remember, this is the larger bottle. This one I can already tell. See? I didn't do that. I didn't put any glue on it. This is the resin. It's not as sticky as it could be, but it's still very, very tacky. I stick it to my hand, I shouldn't be able to turn my hand sideways and not have it fall off. The other ones, I mean, they don't stick. I can push them and they don't stick to anything. The Blue Moon, big bottle, after 4 minutes, is still extremely tacky. Now, I am going to do another test. For those of you that might be a little bit skeptical, I am going to use the Blue Moon again. And I'm going to do this one again, and I'll explain to you in a second why. But I'm going to do the Blue Moon again, and I'm going to put it in a different mold. I'm going to put it in one of these skinny molds, small one. Actually, no, I'd skip that. I'm sorry. I'm going to put it back in the same mold, but I'm going to give it longer time. Even though the resin says on the package that it should only take 2 to 4 minutes, I'm going to give it the benefit of the doubt and I'm going to let it stay on there a little bit longer, but I'm going to do that one last for the big bottle. Okay, if you remember, the Letts resin has to go in for at least 6 minutes. So this has 2 more minutes to go. I'm going to use this one and I'm going to put it in one of these larger molds. Let's say this one over here. And like I said before, it really doesn't matter how big the mold is. The only reason I'm doing this one is because I have noticed that if it's deeper, it doesn't cure as well as if you have a shallow one. So again, it's not a big deal. I could probably put this in longer and it would be fine. It's a matter of just playing around and see what works. Sometimes this is just hit or miss. Sometimes it works really well for certain applications if I do many coats of thinness versus the longer, thicker ones. If you notice, these are very shallow. I tried to put the put, I use this mold particularly because it is very shallow, but I don't know if you can really see that there. They're all about the same thickness, and the only one that's sticky is the Blue Moon. So we're going to put this back in. We'll give it a couple more minutes. Get rid of that bubble. I'm going lamp back over here so you can see the timer. And away we go. Be back with you shortly. Okay, we're back. I'm going to take this out and flip it over. So, a couple things that I want to point out. The Let's resin had already been in the light for 4 minutes. I put it in for another 4 minutes. So, the Let's resin has been in there for a total of 8 minutes. This one has been in there for 4 minutes. And I want to clarify one thing that I thought might have been a little bit misleading or confusing. So the size of the mold doesn't matter. Like I said before, it doesn't matter if this is wider, skinnier, whatever. What matters is the depth that you pour things, which is why I tried to keep everything at about the same depth. Trying to make sure everything was about as much as I could judge, about the same thickness. If anything, the Blue Moon one was a little bit thinner than the other ones, which shouldn't make any difference. It was in there the same amount of time. They all have the same curing time, so they should have all been cured in the same amount of time. One thing to bear in mind is that, as mentioned on the Let's resin bottle, the final curing time can depend on the resin thickness, weather, and UV lamp wattage. So check out your manufacturer of the resin that you have when you get it, because if it's it should say in the directions that if you want to pour something a little bit bigger, like this one here, for example, I poured this one deep specifically for a reason, because the thicker the layers are of your resin, the longer it's going to take to cure, and the more likely it may be that it won't cure completely. So if you're doing something that's got some size to it, thickness-wise, not width like this, but how thick it is, then you want to make sure you do it in layers rather than trying to pour the whole thing in and then trying to cure it like that. All right. So that having been said, I did notice our weather is very damp and cold here today. It's relatively warm where I am right now because I have all the lights on and everything. But I did want to give the Let's resin, whoops, this one, a fighting chance because it does say 6 to 20 minutes, and I'm not going to sit here and try to cure this for 20 minutes. It could be that it takes that long. It could be the type of day it is out. It could be a lot of things. So I did give it 8 minutes just to give it a fighting chance, like I said. All right, enough said. So this is the little bottle that we've been playing with. I told you sometimes I can have issues with this one, maybe not curing all the way through, but that actually did a really good job. I did overpour it. I did pour it thicker. It's a substantial piece. Maybe it doesn't feel as smooth and nice as the Decorum resin that I use, but it's totally fine. It definitely cured. It's not sticky. It's not tacky. I can't stick it to my hands and have it. Yeah, it doesn't stick. The Blue Moon still sticks. Just want to point that out. All right. Last but not least is the Let's resin. Pop this out of here. It's been in there for a long time. And this is still just a little bit tacky. And it's only just. And the reason I have problems with a little bit tacky versus being not tacky at all is that after you have handled it for a while, even if it's slightly tacky, it's going to start getting a cloudy appearance to it. It's not going to be as pristine and nice as you would want it to be. So that's just something to keep an eye out for. Now, it is much more cured than it has been when I've used it in the past, so it could be that I just need to leave it in there for even longer. And that's totally fine. If that's what it is, as long as you know that, then work with that. All right, so now the moment of truth. We're going to test out this Blue Moon resin again. And I want to make the test as even as I possibly can. So here's the new bottle. I have never even opened this or used it. I just took it out of the package. You can see that the cap is still pretty pristine. There's no goopiness like there is with my other ones. So let's see here. What can we use? I just want to keep it a pretty simple test. I think. I think I'll use this triangle down here that I just used for the Let's Resin for the bigger bottle. Just gotta get going here. And I'm not, as you saw with my the overpours and with some of the spillage, I'm not being super cautious with this. This is just purely for demonstration purposes. So you would want to get the bubbles out. Be careful about how you put the resin in, all of that good stuff. So that's the big bottle that I already had. Here's the new bottle that I haven't cracked open yet. And I'm just going to use the other little triangle next to it. I don't know if this has got a safety seal on it. Let me check. Hold on. It does. That's why it's not coming out. Get that off. Sorry, give me a second to find something I can get it off with. Oops, I hit you. Apologies. Let's get that safety seal off of here. And as I say in all my videos, do as I say, not as I do. If you're working with any sort of resin, you should have gloves on. I do not, and I will clean my fingers off as soon as I get this label off because I don't want that resin all over my fingers. So I just took the little protective barrier out. I've got some resin on my fingers, so I'm going to spray my hands with some alcohol to get rid of the stickiness. All right, let's get back to it here. So let's put this resin in. Smaller bottles sometimes can be a little bit harder to squeeze, which is why I like the big ones. And plus, it's more economical. All right. I did a really crappy job filling that up, but here goes. Right. And I want you guys to have faith and what I'm doing here. So I'm going to bring my lamp back over so you can see the timer on it. And because the blue moon says 2 to 4 minutes, we're going to put this in for 4 minutes. The big triangle, remember, I don't know if I'm out of frame, I'm sorry. The big triangle is the old bottle, the little triangle is the new, smaller bottle. We'll do a countdown again. And we'll flip it over after 2 minutes and go down to another 2 minutes. Okay, we're back. That is it. 4 minutes total. So I'm going to take that out. Got to get this lamp out of the way. And we're going to take a look and see how these did. All right, so if you remember, lower corner was the big bottle, upper corner, or the bigger, the not bigger, the other one was the smaller bottle. Let's take the first one out. Two minutes on each side, and that sucker is sticky. You watch the timer count down. Now, I don't want my hands to have residue on them, so I'm wiping them on a towel here. I don't want them to be sticky. I want this to be an accurate test. It is still tacky. But it's okay. It's not as sticky as this one that just came out where it's like fully stuck to my hand. So, what do I conclude with all of this? First of all, very candidly, resins are not all created equally. The bottle can tell you that it takes 2 to 4 minutes. If you were to get this resin in your local Michaels and you bought the UV lamp that comes with it, my personal feeling, and this is just my own thoughts, you might have a different opinion. The lamp that you can purchase there that will supposedly cure this resin will not cut it. I have used lower wattage lamps, as you've seen in my previous video, and this cures even stickier if that's possible. The little bottle here did cure better, and I still don't think it would cure properly under the little light that you can get at Michael's. So, thoughts about the light first before I go into thoughts about the resin. First of all, thank you to viewers that are out there that had suggested getting a stronger wattage lamp. There have been, if you go out and you kind of research a little bit, you're going to find that there's a lot of goods and bads about the higher wattage lamps. So I did some research before I bought the one that I have and made sure that it was safe to use with resin, that I didn't have any issues with it. Some people say that it will overheat the resin, which is possible. It may be overheating the resin. Maybe that's why it's still sticky. It's going to be kind of up to you to do some trial and error. What I can tell you is the higher wattage does work better. I don't think the little mini lamp that comes with the Blue Moon resin is going to cure your stuff. It will probably over a long period of time, but then you might as well put it out in the sun. That's my thought. Anyway, higher wattage lamp, the better things will work for you. If you follow the instructions on the bottle and do what the bottle says, take the weather and so forth into consideration, you should have fairly decent success with it. If you follow some of the resins that I have here, you might have better success, but again, it's all up to personal use. So I do highly recommend that you take a peek at the resins that are online, see how they cure, read the reviews, make sure that you're getting something that at least has some decent reviews before you purchase it. But it is something that you're going to have to test out. So my thoughts about the resin. As long as you've got a good, decent wattage lamp, this, I think, is a product of oldness. So what I mean by that is this bottle here, I think, sat wherever it has been for a very, very long time. I have read information online that says that older UV resin may not cure. I think that because this is a bigger bottle, because it costs more to buy, obviously, because there's more in it, it doesn't get used up as quickly. It probably sat around on the shelf for a very long time before I purchased it. That could be the reason that it's not curing the way that it should. And the reason that I think that is because the smaller bottle, when cured at the same time, in the same type of mold, for the same duration, same flipping over everything, same lamp, did cure. It probably could have used another minute, so take the 2 to 4 minutes with a grain of salt. But if you do want to try this out because you have a Michaels near you and you want to play with UV resin and you haven't tried it before, I do recommend getting the smaller bottle. Do not get the lamp that they sell in the store. If you want to do that, you might as well, like I said, take it out into the sunshine because the sunshine will cure it just as well. Follow the instructions for curing it outside. But you should have pretty good success with the smaller bottle. The larger bottle, there is no manufacture date. There's nothing printed anywhere on the bottle or on the packaging or in the leaflet to say when it was manufactured and how old is too old. So you're not going to know unless you buy it and you try it. So unfortunately, I spent a lot of money on this big bottle and I'm not going to really get any use out of it. I've tried it and tried it and tried it, and it's just not curing. So I am happy that I bought the smaller bottle so I could at least test it out against the larger one and let you guys know what my thoughts were. Let's resin. I think that given the right amount of time and the right conditions, that this would work fine. So I'm glad I have it as a backup in case I want it. This one was good. It doesn't cure well under lower wattage lamps. I will tell you that right now. So if you have a lower wattage lamp or something that you're just not sure about, you're probably not going to have very good success with it. The Decorum, I was curing this under my 32, I think it was a 32 watt lamp, and under the 72 watt lamp for the same amount of time, and it cured up beautifully. I had a small bottle of this that I bought and used, and I liked it so much that I went and got a larger bottle, and it has given me no problems. It has cured beautifully every time I've used it. So my recommendations are still this brand. Definitely go with the Michaels if you don't want to order online. Get the small bottle. Let's Resin if you want a little bit something that's a little bit more name brand friendly. It's a reputable company. I love Let's Resin products. This works great too. You just have to give it a longer time to cure. Not sure why the difference is there. This says it's a thin type. These other ones don't really say. They just say that they're hard. So it could be that this is a thinner resin. It could take longer. That I don't know. I'd have to do some more research on it. Anyway, I'm not going to talk your ear off anymore. I hope this was helpful. I wanted to do an updated video just to give you guys some more information so you can make a better choice about the UV resin that you use. Leave a like below if you like this content and you'd like to see me make more. I can do some projects with the UV resin and show you how it works on something a little bit better. But definitely give UV resin a try. I still love it. I still love to use it for top coating things. I will often put it on pieces that I've made with polymer clay and it cures up beautifully. And that's the one thing that I wanted to mention is that you don't want the sticky, tacky part of the resin after you've cured it, because if it becomes sticky and tacky, if you touch it like this to, get it ready to make jewelry out of it or something, you're going to end up leaving a cloudy residue all over it and it's just going to ruin your piece. So test it out before you put it on something to top coat it is my recommendation if you haven't used it before. But like I was saying, if you like the content, like it so that other people will be able to see it and like it as well. Subscribe below if you haven't subscribed already, if you're a new viewer. If you're a returning viewer, I'm so happy that you were here. And if you're a new viewer, I hope you enjoyed it and will come back and see more. Take care, everybody. It's been great to share this little bit of time with you. We'll talk again soon. Bye.